Hello, buddy pal. I know you had a buddy puma or saber tooth. Hello. Oh, he just ducked underneath it. Nope. I don't want to battle it unless I have a bullet in it, because they do a lot of damage. This one's also a level 4, just like Kermit Jr. There we go, he is dead. And we're out of food, so we need to head home anyway. Let's check on his food, and then we're going to come back in a little while. Again, that Argentavis just keeps taunting me. Alright, after this Argentavis, we're definitely heading home. Alright. He's fucking done. Let's go ahead and grab Fluffly. Run home. Let's check on the food of Kermit Jr. Go ahead and get his Topor maxed out. He's already down 200, so that's pretty good. Let's get his Topor maxed out before we piece and do a little bit of work on the base and stuff. His Topor will definitely last. That's a lot of Topor for such a low level mammal or dinosaur. Probably use one more and then we're going to piece. So he's going to be max unconscious. His food is probably going to be, I'd say we're going to start pumping food into him when he's around 200 food. We'll kill all these mammoths, we'll kill all these brontos and just pump them full of prime meat. Let's go ahead down to the home base. If we can cook food really fastly, which we can because we have the industrial grill, then we'll head over to where I'm building, get a little work done on the base, and then come back and he should be completely starved. So this is kind of how I'm going to be doing taming now. When it comes to carnivores, it makes sense to starve. I know it's not any, well, it's not any faster, but it technically is, because if he's fully eating only prime, now I'm finding so many saber-toothed tigers now that I'm taming one. If he's fully eating only prime, it actually will make it faster. So starving him will make it so he's constantly eating prime. I could technically tame him, put regular meat in him, and then just put prime in when I can. But then you have to wait for the regular food meter to go down and then have him eat the prime. And then sometimes when that happens, the prime goes bad and it causes a situation that just isn't ideal. I think we went the complete wrong direction. I'm pretty sure I'm lost as fuck. I think we need to actually go over the other side of the mountain. Yeah, we need to go to the left of the mountain. I just need food really bad is the situation. I could set up a fire and everything, but I'm too lazy to do that. I have to get stones and wood and flint. But why do that if we have a freaking metal industrial grill at home? But I'm going to start taming like this more often, where I down it in an area where I feel that it's relatively safe. And then from there, kind of like go get some other work done while it's starving. I'll probably do that to herbivores as well, just so they eat a fuck ton of berries really fast and it just feels like it's faster. If you don't have to be there while it's eating to make sure that it has berries in it, then it's the easiest thing ever. Maybe with herbivores, I might just crank it full of Topor and then just have it eat a fuck ton of berries and so on and so forth and not have it be a situation. Alright, so we should be getting towards base camp right now. I'm not sure, like I'm in the trees right now, so I'm pretty freaking lost, to be honest. One really cool thing is the long neck rifle that we got last episode. Really freaking cool that we got one, especially that it has extra damage. It has 8% extra damage, which is even cooler. I'm so lost. Let me get down to the water. I know how to get back to Kermit. I just don't know how to get back to base. Like, I know from base where Kermit is what I'm saying. But I don't know from Kermit where base is. I definitely went the wrong direction, I think. Yeah. Is this where we landed our parachutes that one time? Okay, yeah, there's the blue obelisk. I'm really close to old base. Wow, I ran this far? Damn, I didn't know I got this far off track. Alright, well, let's get to running, huh? Oh, that's blue obelisk. That's green obelisk. Is that blue or green? We're not that close to blue. I'm pretty sure base is just this direction, right? Oh god. I am more than lost, guys. haven't really navigated, like, I've only navigated to and from certain spots, if that makes sense. Like, I've navigated from the old base to the new base. But once I get turned around, I should have left a different area. Yeah, I should have went the other way when I came to Kermit. That is the green obelisk. But we're in between the blue and the green. I'm getting too close to the green, so I need to go the other way. I couldn't really tell the color from that distance. It just looks blue because of the sky behind it. Alright, so yeah, we are this way. I'm not too far away from base. Oh, I just wish this guy had more stamina. Come on, level up so I can give you more stamina. I don't really care that... I mean, his stamina's good. He has 940 stamina. It's just how fast he goes through stamina and how slow his stamina increases. Let's remember that there's four Brontos down here. For five Brontos down here. Whenever we need Prime, definitely come over here. I'm starting to get tired because I haven't eaten. Sorry, T-Rex. I can't have you chilling around here if I'm going to come down and eat these Brontos. There's actually an albino T-Rex right here. Fluffy, you want to kill one of your kind?
Yes, master.
It's like, okay, let's go. Dum 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 dum. Eat, you motherfucker. Again, I just can't have him eating all these. Oh, looks like I'm eating all of them because they're attacking me. Alright. Probably got a fuck ton of prime on us now. We can actually just put this in the fridge and maybe run it back. Stamina! Yay! There's another albino T-Rex right across the river. Albino T-Rexes are not that common, so that's pretty cool to see a bunch of them. Wow, there's a lot of T-Rexes on the coast right now. Holy fuck. A lot of stegos, a lot of brontos, a lot of everything. The thing is, if they were to go ahead and make prime stack, taming would be 7,000 times easier. Because the way stacks work is the top piece on the stack is what goes bad when it does go bad. But right now, as is, raw prime meat doesn't stack. So it goes bad one at a time. So that causes a lot of issues. And if it were to be stacked like regular raw meat, then carnivore taming would be probably just as easy as anything else. Like, it's just, it kind of sucks that it works that way. And I don't know if it's intentional or they were just trying it out for the alpha or the early access or whatever this is. I'm not really even sure what this is. It's just early access, I know that. Because I believe their full release is when they're going to console, like next June or July or something, I don't remember. But, wow, I'm really far away. That's the mountain I need to get to. Where? I don't even know. I don't even know, guys. That's the blue obelisk. I'm about to just go back inland and go, yeah, I'm going back inland. I think we went to the wrong river or something. I really do think we just went to the wrong river. I think we needed to go the other way and we ended up like on a different river on the other side of the mountain. Alright, well, I'm gonna have to just go ahead and bite a bullet here and just make a campfire instead of heading home. Because we got lost. Thatch, flint, stone, and wood. I actually have to equip my stuff? No. Alright. Got our wood. Got our thatch. Got our flint. Now we just need stone. Just cook up a little bit of meat. Just to keep us over. It is hot, so we're eating a lot more food and drinking a lot more water. Alright. Mr. Campfire. Probably don't have enough stone yet. One stone, of course. Here we go. Craft Mr. Campfire. We can actually craft... Is this a better shotgun? 110% damage shotgun. It's a pretty good craftable to get. Let's go ahead and just slap this bad boy on the ground. Gotta fill her up with some wood. Light it up. Hello, Fluffly. Give me some of your meat. Can't believe I got lost that easily. Like, you'd be surprised at how big and how scary this map can be, especially when you just start playing. It's definitely not, like, like it is now. I mean, it's not scary for me because I have, like, the T-Rex. Nothing, anything that comes out of the woods, you're like, oogala boogala, I could just eat it. But when you're on foot and you feel this small, like, look how big the trees are and the canopies, it gets really daunting. And then also you have this huge fucking massive map of, like, over a kilometer in both directions, and it's just, what do you do? You know what I mean? You don't want to go inland, because everybody was told not to go inland when you were a fresh spawn, because you'd get absolutely fucked up just by the amount of raptors and all that kind of shit that just want to eat your guts. So, like I said, I mean, it's easy to get lost even with someone like Fluffly on me. I mean, usually I don't get lost as easy with someone like a Sabretooth, because I can weave in and around rocks and I don't have to kind of work with the terrain. I can kind of just go my own way. But with someone like Fluffly, he can't get over even the smallest of rocks because he's just so large, and it kind of becomes an issue that he can't jump as well. Since I'm regaining health back, I'm actually losing food faster. That's probably why I've been getting so hungry. We're going to eat two more pieces of meat, and then we're going to head back up to the mountain. I mean, I probably have to pump narcotics back into Kermit again and probably just start feeding him now instead of going ahead and running home or something. I'll get a campfire set up over there. I do not want it to become nighttime before I get over there. It's actually relatively getting really close to nighttime. About 2200 is when nighttime swings around. So we want to definitely get back over to where Kermit is sitting, and let's go check on him. Like I said, just like getting around these giant ass rocks with how bad of a turn radius a T-Rex has is, like I said, it's a lot easier to get lost because you can't just straight line to where you want to go. You have to succumb to the terrain. We're already up on the mountain. We literally just, I don't know, we got really turned around there. Let's go ahead and just go find Kermit again. Hello, Kermit lookalike. I killed everything in the area, so I'm hoping that none of the Argentavises or Dimorphodons respawned and started eating him. Because that's going to make me sad if that's the case. That's my brother's mountain right there. That's where he's built. He's built just underneath that mountain. Here's actually a Kermit lookalike right here. This would be the ideal tamed Sabretooth, but we're going to go ahead and eat him just to make the other Kermit safe. He actually took two hits, level 19, wow. There's an Argentavis floating overhead, which scares me, but I don't think we're quite to where Kermit is. Gotta wrap around a little bit more. I just ran in the complete wrong direction. I don't know how I did that. I mean, like, see the giant fucking mountain, and I went the other way. That was really stupid of me. All right. Sun's going down. Let's just get to Kermit and figure out what we're gonna do. We need to get a ton of prime. We have some on us. Enough to kind of tickle his fancy a little bit. I believe. Where was he? Is it more on the other side of the mountain? Yeah, we need to keep wrapping around. This is where a Sabretooth comes in really handy, because just going around these rocks is one of the toughest things ever with this giant fucking dinosaur. Don't get me wrong, he's great for getting prime, he's great for just kind of like fucking everything up and doing what he does. But when it comes to climbing up mountains, Sabretooth is definitely the way to go. I'm killing these mammoths so that I can have more prime than I could ever need when I get to Kermit. I have like probably over 10 prime on me right now. It goes bad in probably about 5 minutes on some of them. It goes bad on 10 minutes on most of them. Got a little raptor squadron right here. Alright, fingers crossed, guys. I do not want to come to him and have him be eaten or gone. Or almost unconscious. That would be the worst situation because my heart will sink. I walked up this path. This is how I got turned around, because I thought I was on the side that I needed to be on, but I wasn't. Looks like the Sabretooths have respawned up here. So if you want Sabretooth Tigers, man, this is definitely the mountain to come to, because they seem to be pretty damn interested in this mountain for some reason. Yo, come here. I can't have you randomly spotting me and eating Kermit. I don't think they're hostile towards T-Rexes. Because who would be hostile towards a T-Rex? He's still there. He's still there. He's still there. I saw him. I'm shooting this Argentavis out of the sky. Alright. What's your unconsciousness like, my dude? He's about halfway unconscious. Halfway not hungry. Do I want to crank Prime into him right now? I don't. I really want to get him a lot lower than that. But we should actually, now that I know where home is, we should head home and just craft to get a whole bunch of food for ourselves. I'm going to do another perimeter check just to make sure there's no other, oh my god, okay. There is some Argentavises around, huh? This other one up here. There we go. That's very satisfying, shooting those Argentavises. Alright, let's keep perimeter checking. Stego's still stuck. Bronto's still stomping around, nothing eating at his legs. Killed the two Sabertooths on the mountain like I did last time. I don't see anything bad happening. Let's go ahead and snag a standing torch out of Fluffly real quick. And we're going to place one of them down right next to him so that there's no question of how to find him. Apparently, building is obstructed. Okay. Okay, game. I can't place a standing torch down. Is it too steep here, game? Too steep for you? Alright, well, we're gonna put a standing torch wherever we can. At least to kind of, like, mark the area. I know a lot of this Prime's gonna go bad, guys, inside Fluffly, but it's fine that it goes bad because we have so many dinosaurs in the area where we can just snatch up as much Prime as we can. I need to get home and I need to get food inside myself or I'm gonna start losing health, and it's kind of a shitty situation where my health is low, so it's making me eat more, and then when I run out of food, then I lose more health, and it's a bad situation to be in. So we're gonna run home real quick. We're gonna industrial fire like a fuck ton of meat, take like 50 with us. And then we're gonna go ahead and get a fuck ton of Prime, and we're gonna crank it inside Kermit, and we're gonna have ourselves a saber-toothed tiger in frickin' no time. I'm gonna leave the mammoth here because I don't want him going bad inside Fluffly's belly. Alright. Like I said, this dinosaur, I don't know. I need myself a saber tooth. I need something that could just fucking jump and get down places so much faster. And this is not cutting for me right now. And I felt bad. I needed a land mount that could do what I need to do. Alright. Made our way down the mountain. The base is just pretty much right across the water here. We can see part of the bridge right there. Okay. I can't believe I went the complete opposite direction of the base. That's the stupidest thing I've ever done. Alright. Let's go ahead, run inside, cook up a ton of this meat. Here we are, Fluffly. We're home. Don't worry. I didn't get lost too long. I know I let you down. Alright. We're gonna close the gate. I just want to move Fluffly in all the way so we can grab the meat off of him really easy. Here we go. And let's get inside. Cook up a whole bunch of this Fluffly meat. We don't need all of that, but we can put some in the fridge for later. Because we are doing some other stuff besides just taming Kermit. Gonna do a little bit of that base building that I wanted to do, but I got caught up in getting lost. And let's go ahead and turn it on.